What's up guys, in this tutorial I will show you how to play Real Racing 3 on your Windows PC or Mac using a gamepad or controller. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. To play Real Racing 3 on your PC, you must use an Android emulator such as BlueStacks. BlueStacks is a popular choice to play mobile games on your PC as it's optimized for playing mobile games. Click on the first link in the description to get to this page. From here, download the BlueStacks 5 setup installer to your system. This should take a second to complete and you can follow the install wizard to install the application to your system. After the installation is complete, BlueStacks should open up automatically. Next, open your Play Store and ensure you're logged in with your Google account. Search for Real Racing 3 and download the game to your BlueStacks emulator. This might take a few minutes to complete, depending on your network connection. While downloading the game, you should take a look at your emulator settings. Click on this gear icon to access these settings. In the gamepad section, enable the gamepad detection option. This will allow BlueStacks to recognize and receive input from your controller. Below, set the gamepad input settings to automatic. And set the gamepad vibration option to your personal preference. It may not have any effect on Real Racing 3. After connecting your controller or gamepad, it will be recognized by BlueStacks and show up as an alternative to your keyboard and mouse. In the Performance tab, you should set these according to your PC's performance. Allocate a high amount of CPU cores if you don't have a lot of other applications running in the background. The same goes for your memory allocation. For users with 4 GB or less RAM, set this option to low. Under Performance mode, make sure to set this option to balanced. This will reduce the memory and CPU usage if your PC lags or you otherwise encounter low performance. I prefer to enable the high FPS option and set the frame rate of the emulator according to my screen refresh rate. If you need more clarification on your refresh rate, right-click your desktop and select Display Settings. From here, make sure that the correct display is selected. Scroll down and click on Advanced Display. This will allow you to preview your refresh rate and change it if you want. Also, if you troubleshoot performance issues, enable the FPS counter option. Set the display orientation to landscape in your display settings and choose a fitting resolution to play Real Racing 3 on your monitor. You can also adjust the size of this window by dragging its corners. You can leave the other settings to the default option and play Real Racing 3 to see how well it runs on your PC. You will see a pop-up that your controller has been detected when launching the game for the first time. Click on the keyboard icon in your BlueStacks menu bar. Make sure the game controls option is enabled, which will enable you to see your current keyboard or controller layout, which should work fine for beginners. Access your controls editor in the game controls, which will enable you to add controls such as a D-pad on the left side to control your steering with your keyboard or controller controls. You can adjust the size and buttons of your D-pad or other controls. Make sure to save your changes when you are done, and then you can enable the on-screen controls option and change its opacity to see how the controller button layout looks. Next, navigate to your in-game settings. In the Controls section, you have the option to change your controls layout, but make sure to adjust it in your BlueStacks Controls Editor. In your Display settings, adjust the HUD options to your liking, as well as the camera settings, which can have a lot of impact on the way the game looks. These steps and more information will be available in our extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions and see you in the next one.